Hello everybody, I'm Jeffrey. Today I'm going to talk about, do you need to learn math if you want to learn how to code? The short answer is no, you don't need to learn math in order to do coding. But a more responsible answer would be, it depends. It depends on what kind of software engineering you want to do, and for certain fields of software engineering, it's actually required. For those fields that don't require math, knowing math is actually beneficial in terms of landing an interview, passing the interview, and get a job offer, because recruiters will generally prefer a STEM degree, and you will generally perform better in a interview. At least you will know how to calculate space complexity and time complexity. A lot of engineers nowadays are doing web development, including myself, which means that they're either doing front-end or back-end or just full-stack development, which is a little bit of both. In front-end, we'll use JavaScript and TypeScript, and in back-end, there's all kinds of languages available for us to use. And when we are developing, we generally won't start from scratch. We'll use some frameworks and tools such as Angular, React, Vue, Django, or Spring that's built and optimized by others to help us complete our job. Besides being web engineers, you can also be a DBA, tinkering with database, and you can also be a QA engineer, running tests to ensure system is healthy, or DevOps engineer, or mobile engineer, developing iOS and Android apps. All of these jobs don't require you to know any math, and you can do just fine without getting a math degree. Even if there are some points in your career that you do need to use math, for example, you want to calculate the square root of 7, you're likely to use a library that's written by others, probably by very smart people who spend a great deal of time optimizing it. A qualified software engineer is lazy, and by that I mean we don't like reinventing the wheels. So if there's a better library out there that's free to use, we like to use them. Personally, for my past 4 internships, I've never even once used any math. The math courses that I took, such as calculus, multivariable calculus, linear algebra, statistics, combinatorics, and real analysis, have been completely useless in my career. I didn't take any derivative to get all my jobs done. So why do we need to learn all these useless stuff just to never see them again after we graduate? Well, that's not the right way to see it. Even though we'll probably never see them again at work, the benefits we get from learning all those stuff and the struggle we've been through are unconsciously fused into how we think and the way that we approach to solve a problem. Yes, it will make you a great problem solver. And problem solving is actually the core of software engineering. And there are some math you just have to know in order to become a better software engineer. For example, Big O notations. You need to learn them in order to assess space and time complexity. However, I also want to mention that learning math is not the only way to improve problem solving skills. A lot of other professions also require problem solving skills. For example, an Uber driver needs it, a lawyer needs it, and even a plumber needs problem solving skills. Frankly, all kind of professions that you can think of require problem solving skills. Therefore, as long as you have logical thinking and is able to reason about things, you can be a programmer. But are all of this knowledge really 100% useless? Not really. Remember what I said in the beginning of this video about different fields of software engineering? Yes, some fields of software engineering do require you to know a lot of math. And these jobs usually require more advanced degrees, such as machine learning engineers, computer graphics engineers, and those engineers that require multidisciplinary expertise, such as game engine developers. For these jobs, you need some specific skills. If you want to do machine learning, you gotta be good at statistics. Statistics is the backbone of all machine learning algorithms. And you also need to learn multivariable calculus and linear algebra. For game engineers, they also need to know math. And if they're dealing with some simulation stuff, which is very likely considering all the fancy games we have right now, they also need to know physics stuff, which is really hard. But at the end of the day, how many of us are actually doing all this stuff? I don't know the specific number, but I would imagine it's a small percentage. And for an ordinary person like me, I can still get away with not knowing too much of math and still do a good job and make a decent living. So if you want to be a programmer and you don't know much math, no problem, you'll be totally fine. This is it for today's video. If you like my video, please like and subscribe. And if you think any different, please comment below and let me know. And see you next time.